Good afternoon, students. In the last video, we done Unit 4 Electronic Spectroscopy. Last topic is Beetz-Lambert's law and dissociation constant of a weak acid. In this video, we will start Unit 2, that is NMR. Unit 2 in general chemistry is NMR 1. Nuclear magnetic resonance 1. The nuclear magnetic resonance 1 deals with a proton NMR. Proton NMR, nothing but nature of proton and a type of proton and environment of proton can be determined in this unit, that is NMR, nuclear magnetic resonance. First, let's see introduction. Introduction of NMR. The phenomena, NMR phenomena, is first reported by E.L. Purcell and Felix Black. E.L. Purcell and Felix Black in 1946. The phenomenon is first reported by E.L. Purcell and Felix Black in 1946. Further, they jointly awarded a Nobel Prize in 1952. Nuclear spin is the basis of NMR. NMR is the abbreviation of nuclear magnetic resonance. In presence of a magnetic field, in presence of magnetic field means applied magnetic field, nothing but in presence of external magnetic field, nucleus undergoes a spinning. So that is a nuclear spin. That nuclear spin is a main basis of NMR spectroscopy. In NMR, the useful radiation is radio frequency waves. Over 60 years, the NMR technique have become very powerful analytical technique for a determination of structure of molecules with the help of a type of nucleus, nature of nucleus and chemical environment nucleus. So this is the introduction of NMR. Next, let us see the principle involved in NMR. Now let's see principle involved in NMR spectroscopy. Principle is a very important. The principle also said to be spin and magnetic properties of nuclei. Spin and magnetic properties of nuclei. Spin and magnetic properties of nuclei. We already know nucleus have protons and neutrons. Nucleus have protons and neutrons. These protons and neutrons are said to be nuclear particles. These nuclear particles have the property of a spin. Nucleus, every atom nucleus having protons and neutrons. That protons and neutrons are said to be nuclear particles. That nuclear particles have the property of spin. Due to having a property of spin, proton spins its own axis and produces spin angular momentum. Similarly, neutron also spins its own axis and produces spin angular momentum. The combination of a proton spin and a neutron spin, the net spin is said to be nucleus spin. The nucleus spin is represented with a capital I. Nucleus spin is represented with a capital I. This is also known as a spin quantum number. Spin quantum number, nothing but I. The nucleus spin is an individual value, nothing but experimental value. Different types of nucleus having a different value. This is, we cannot calculate it in theoretically. Just it is considered to take experimental value. The experimental value of nuclear spin is depends upon empirical rules. First, let's see. What are the empirical rules useful to calculation of spin active and inactive of NMR nucleus? First, type of nuclei. Proton number and neutron number, spin active or inactive, nothing but I. Simply, a nucleus have even number of protons and even number of neutrons. A nucleus consists even number of proton and even number of neutron. I value zero. That type of proton is said to be inactive, spin inactive or NMR inactive. Simply, if a nucleus consists even number of proton and even number of neutron, I value always zero consisting nucleus is said to be inactive nucleus. Next, suppose proton number is odd, neutron number also odd, that nucleus consists I value always an integer numbers, the integer numbers like negative to positive values. According to our knowledge, just we observed positive integer numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4 for different types of nucleus. So that such type of nucleus is said to be active, NMR active or spin active nucleus. And finally, proton number even, neutron number odd or vice versa. Proton number odd, neutron number even. Such type of nuclei consist rational numbers. The rational number consisting spin value, rational number consisting nuclei, also active nuclei. The most preferable spin active nucleus consist I value always half. Here rational numbers like 1 by 2, 3 by 2, 5 by 2, etc. So these are empirical rules. Empirical rules says whether the nucleus is spin active or inactive. Suppose a nucleus consists even number of proton, even number of neutron, that nucleus always spin inactive. Odd number of neutron, odd number of proton gives integer numbers, that is active. Or odd number of neutron and even number of proton or vice versa, that always gives a rational number of spin value, that is also active. Finally, the most preferable spin active nucleus having I value always off. So this is a principle, nothing but spin and magnetic properties of nuclei and empirical rules. Now let's see examples with respect to empirical values. Type of nuclei examples. We have a tabular form like type of nuclei, proton number, neutron number, spin active or inactive nature, and I value. First, let's say helium-2 nucleus. The helium-2 nucleus have helium atomic number 4 and mass is 4. So that helium consists 2 protons and 2 neutrons. 2 protons, 2 neutrons, nothing but even combination. Even combination spin is always inactive spin. I value is 0. Next, C12 have 6 protons and 6 neutrons. 6 protons and 6 neutrons, this is also inactive, 0. Next, oxygen 8 and 16, nothing but 8 protons, protons nothing but atomic number. Atomic number protons equal 8 protons. Oxygen atomic number 8. That's why let's take 8 protons. Remaining number neutron nothing but 8. 8 plus 8 combination. Same even combination gives rise to inactive I value 0. Next nuclei is boron 10. Boron atomic number 5. So that's why number of protons 5. Next number of neutron also 5. This is odd and odd combination. The odd and odd combination gives active spin value or active spin. I value is always 3. Next, nitrogen 14. Nitrogen atomic number 7, 7 plus 7 combination. The 7 plus 7 combination also odd and odd gives rise to active, gives 1 value. And finally, C13 gives 6 plus 7 combination, even and odd combination. Even and odd combination gives active, this gives rise to half value. The proton only have a single proton and neutron always zero. There is no neutrons in proton. That's why hydrogen proton having a mass is one. This is active spin value is half. And next, P31 nuclei, nitrogen 15 nuclei, oxygen 17 nuclei, and fluorine 19 nuclei. P31 nuclei, phosphorus atomic number 15, that's why protons 15, neutrons 16. So this is also active spin, active nuclei, spin value always half. And nitrogen 15. 7 and 8 combination, 7 and 8 combination also active, proton-neutron ratio, this is also gives rise to half value. O17 gives 8 and 9 combination, this is even and odd combination also active, this is also gives rise to half value. And finally, fluorine atomic number 9, that's why let's take a proton ratio, proton number is 9. And 10 is a neutron, this is active nuclei, spin value is half. And boron 11, 5 and 6 combination, this is also active, the active nucleus have 3/2 spin value. Finally, I will give the conclusion. The conclusion is the most preferable spin active nuclei have, I value is always half. In the first semester, we have only proton NMR with respect to proton. Proton nothing but just we calculate number of protons and chemical environment of protons and nature of proton. In the second semester, we will take P31 discussion, F19 discussion, and some amount of N15 discussion. In the first semester, just we will discuss proton NMR with respect to proton and nature of proton. So this is a spin and a magnetic properties of nuclei, nothing but principle. In the next video, we will discuss the continuation, nothing but instrumentation and terms used in proton NMR.